When I was 5, and this is true, I thought that the images we saw on the movie screen were from a guy standing in front of a light moving little figurines about and casting suspiciously detailed shadows. Of course, when Shannon filmed the following feature story the other day, I finally learned that wasn't the case. So sit back, lean forward, and pay attention to the man behind the curtain.
You're sitting here in the theatre, watching the movie, munching on your popcorn, sipping on your drink, getting angrier and angrier at how much money you wasted to see this piece of shit. But have you ever wondered what goes on up the back there, in the projection booth, and how it all works? Well, even if you haven't wondered that, we're still going to find out anyway, so come on, let's go. Okay, and this is the projection booth area, or bio box. This is a modern multiplex setup with 16 screens, and it's basically just a series of corridors. And as with most modern cinemas, it's all automated. Everything starts and stops by itself, the film, the lights, everything. So only one or two people need monitor all the screenings. Most movies are shot and projected on 35mm film. And at the going rate of 24 frames a second, that's about 45 centimeters of film per second. So for a 2-hour movie, that's about 3.3 kilometers. That's enough film to reach the moon. If you started here. And this is what it looks like. It weighs about 20 kilos and it costs about $2,500 to make each print. But it doesn't arrive at the cinema like this. They split it up into reels about this big. This holds about 20 minutes of footage. So it's roughly about 5 or 6 reels per movie. After all the reels are put together, the entire film is placed on these giant platters and fed into the projector. But these platters only came about in the 1960s, so before that, they had this. Two separate projectors side by side, both facing the same screen. First one would play the first reel, the second one would play the second reel, then the third reel, and so on and back and forth. The hard part was switching between the two projectors without any discernible pause in the movie. And that's when you'd see this thing pop up. It's called a cue mark or a cue dot, not a cigarette burn, as someone's imaginary friend would have you believe. So back in the day, it went like this. The cue mark would flash up with 8 seconds to go in the reel, and you'd start the second projector rolling, with 8 seconds of just blank film or leader. Then another cue mark would appear with 1 second to go, and in that 1 second, you'd switch both the picture and the sound from the first projector to the second projector. Hopefully you wouldn't stuff it up too badly, but even if you did, don't worry, you've got 5 more tries before the movie's out. And just for future reference, if you're all by yourself in the theatre and you need to go to the toilet, don't bang on the window and ask the projectionist to go back, because you can't rewind the film. Projectors are designed to go one way, and that's forward, so it's out of the question. Although you can stop the film. So by all means do that. Bang on the window and ask them to stop, that's fine. And what about a film's aspect ratio? What about it? Well, some films are shot wider than others. There's 1.66, 1.85, 2.35, anamorphic. Depends how pretentious the director is, and you need to be able to show them all on the one projector. So you've got a series of different lenses on the front here that you can just switch around. Otherwise everyone would look really tall and thin. Oof, gross. And if the candy bar prices weren't enough proof of just how profit-minded exhibitors are, check out these things. These little wheels on the roof. They can carry the film from one projector to another theatre, all the way down the hall. So the exhibitor only pays for one print, but they can play it in 2 or more theatres. And it's the same theory with leftover popcorn as well. Projectionists are generally considered to be a bit weird, a bit strange. You know, they're cooped up in here for hours on end, there's no windows, you know, all these different voices coming at you. I'm here chatting with Dan, who's been a projectionist for 7 years. How's it going, Dan? Have you heard that before, that, you know, you're all a bit weird, a bit strange? And there was even a survey done a few years back that said projectionists were the most likely occupation to become serial killers. Have you heard that? That they were going to be, you guys are serial killers? That's a nice shirt. I kind of like that shirt. It's pretty cool. The logo and stuff. Oh no, please don't kill me. No, I don't want to die.
Oh. Oh, shit. A shirt. Cool. Awesome.
Check it out. Yeah, I got my own.
It's a weird smell though. What's it? Is it chemicals or something? And there's not just the different visual formats you've got to worry about, there's the sound as well. There's Dolby Digital 5.1, 6.1, EX, DTS, THX, SDDS. How do they all work? What's the difference between them all? And how do they all get processed up here? But that's a story for another time. We're doing it now. Oh shit. And that's all you need to know about projection booths. Make sure you tune in next time when we'll show you what goes on behind the screen. I don't know what that means. I mean, there's nothing there. It's just a brick wall. I'm tired. I'm going home.